Let us discuss this example. In this example, we have A is a connected subset of matrix space XD. As well as they are given A subset of B subset of A bar. Then we have to conclude about A bar and B. If A is connected, can we say A bar and B both are connected? If they, that means this satisfy this inclusion relation A subset of B, B subset of A bar. Let us discuss. First of all, we will talk about A bar. We will check whether A bar is connected or disconnected. So we will initially, we will assume, let it possible A bar is disconnected. Let us see what will happen. Assume that A bar is disconnected. So we have seen several properties of disconnected set. Okay, we have seen that means equivalent definitions are also there as well as main definition is also there. So let us use one of it. So therefore, what can we write? A bar is equal to P union Q, where what is the condition? P and Q, both of them should be non-empty, right? Second condition, P and Q should be disjoint. And third condition, P and Q are closed. Getting? So, one of the equivalent definitions I have used here. Let us go further. So, what we have basically A subset of A bar. So, we know that this any set is subset of its closure. But A bar is equal to what? P union Q. So therefore, A subset of P union Q, agree with me, A subset of P union Q. See, P and Q are separated sets and A is connected. That means A subset of P or A subset of Q. Let me write that thing. Here, P and Q are separated sets, right? Separated sets. And A is connected. So, then this information they have given, A is connected. So, that's why either A subset of P or A subset of Q. So, therefore, A subset of P or A subset of Q. Let us try to understand this logic by discussing a simple example. Suppose P and Q, I am denoting those sets P and Q by these buckets. These are separated sets. And A, consider one ball, okay, which is connected set. Okay, so this is A means connected set, A means a ball. So we have to put this ball in this union of these two buckets, P and Q. But see, ball is connected, so that's why you can either put this ball in bucket P or you can put this ball in bucket Q. It is not possible to put this ball half part of the here and half part of there. It is possible only when if you cut the ball at the middle and if you put the half part here, half part there, then it will be possible. The information is A is connected. So that's why you cannot cut the ball in two parts. Getting? So that's why either A goes here or A goes there. So one of the possibilities of these two will hold. So let us, without loss of generality, assume that A is subset of P. Either A goes here or A goes there. So that's why I'm considering A goes to P. Let us take bar of both sides closure. This result we have already seen in previous semester. So A bar subset of P bar, right? So A subset of B, then A bar subset of B bar. This result I use. Let us take intersection Q on both sides. So what will happen? So A bar intersection Q subset of P bar intersection Q, right? But see, P bar is basically P. Tell me why. P bar is equal to P because P is closed set. If any set is closed, then its closure is nothing but original set. So P is closed, that's why P bar is equal to P. So what we have got? P intersection Q. Have you seen P intersection Q anywhere? Yes, definitely. P intersection Q is equal to 5 we have. So therefore, this is equal to 5. So what we get basically, A bar intersection Q is subset of phi. Any set is subset of empty set. That means the set is also empty. So therefore, what can we write? A bar intersection Q is equal to phi. Getting? Is equal to phi. So see, therefore, what can we say? A bar intersection Q is equal to phi. This is not possible because A bar is equal to P union Q we have mentioned initially. And Q is not equal to phi, so that's why A bar intersection Q is equal to phi. We get contradiction here. We get contradiction, that means our assumption is wrong. What was our assumption? Our assumption was A bar is disconnected is wrong. That means what is our conclusion? A bar is connected set. Let me write that thing. You can make a screenshot of it. Then we will go further. So A bar is disconnected is wrong. That means what is our conclusion? A bar is connected. In the same way, we can prove B is also connected set. So I'm leaving this second half for exercise for you. Okay, so you can make a screenshot of it. B is also connected. This is our second conclusion. Make a screenshot and then we will stop. Thank you. Bye bye.